Hi there, everyone. It's Damien. I've picked up another problem on the Power Platform community site, and it involves parsing a quote-encapsulated CSV, which normally isn't too much of an issue, but this particular example has commas within the data columns, which makes things slightly difficult. So I've put together a solution that I feel will be worthwhile sharing with you all, and I hope you can watch till the end. So I've got an example CSV taken from the particular case online, and you'll notice that within one of the columns here, I've got a comma. So it's quote encapsulated, and there's a comma in the middle. And we've also got a comma at the end of that record, and similarly with another record in the middle and at the end. So when using the split expression within Power Automate, you'll inadvertently create extra columns, which is not what you're looking for. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to open up my Power Automate solution and walk you through it. So first off, I've got my compose action, which is the contents of the CSV, and of course you could take this literally from a CSV file using get file. And a second action, which is a return line, which literally is, as it sounds, a return line. I've hit return in a compose, and I use that later on for splitting up this string. So my first real expression is a replace, and what I'm doing with that replace is to replace all double commas with comma double quotes comma. So I hope you're able to follow that. I'm just going to bring across again my Notepad plus. So I'm replacing all instances of a double comma with a comma, double quotes, comma. And the reason for that is, you'll see in some of the examples we've got, if I can find it, where has it gone? There we go. So I've got two commas, and what I want to replace it with is comma, double quote, comma. And that'll be useful for later on, because that's an empty field, and I basically want them to appear like so, and that'll make it easier for splitting later on. So if I move on to the next expression that I've got, it's another replace, and this time I want to replace all instances of a single quote, comma, with a pipe. And so the aim is here, we're going to start turning this into a pipe delimited file, so we don't have a conflict with the commas. So as before, I'll bring across my Notepad, and you can see here replacing all instances of single quote comma with a pipe. And so what that would do is all these examples here, it would convert into a pipe like so. Right, so on to the next particular expression, and this time round we're going to replace all instances of double quotes with nothing. And the reason we're doing that is to tidy up the overall string, because now hopefully we've removed all the other bits and bobs, tidied it up, turn it into a pipe delimited file, but you'll see we're still left with rogue double quotes or single quotes, sorry. So it would just be a case of replacing these with nothing. So that's what the expression would now do. And then finally, I mentioned earlier on that I had the return line. I split this file based on the return line. And so currently this is one long string, I use the return line to split this into an array. And that's then used in my select statement further down. So within the select statement, because we've got a header on this particular CSV, I skip the first line using the output from compose 6. I've manually provided all the key names for the fields within the CSV. And then because I'll be returning line by line all of the individual fields as a string, again I split each item by the pipe, and you'll see that the first one here is called by element 0, second one element 1, third, element 2, and so on, all the way to the last element 8, which is element 7, because it starts from 0, and that will now return me a nicely formatted select array. So I'll run onto a test now. We'll give it a save and test. And we've gone from the original compose here with the CSV, and the final output, if I show it on my screen here, is a nicely formatted array of fields. And you'll see also that within the existing strings, we still have the commas. So we've managed to handle those commas without splitting. So you'll see at the bottom here, I have got a little hidden tidy solution. And if you want to see how I did it in two steps, please keep watching. So what I've done here is I've combined all of these compose actions into a single expression. And there's an easy way of doing this. If I bring across my notepad, so if we look at this example here and we start from the last action, we need to split the output of compose 4 with the return line. So I know that the output of compose 4 is this string or expression here, sorry. So I'm going to replace output compose 4 with that string. And then I know that the output of compose 3 is this expression here. So I'm going to copy that and I'm going to paste that where I've got output of compose 3. And then we know that the output of compose 2 is this expression here. So I can copy that and I can paste that over my output of compose 2. And now we have a single expression that will handle the whole task of running through and replacing all these different strings and characters within our original CSV file. So that's done all within one compose action. And that's basically what this expression is here. And then as before, I've just used exactly the same compose action, but instead of using the compose 6 action, I've used the tidied CSV action. So just one last time, I'll run the test. And if I pop open this scope here, you can see the tidied CSV. The output is a nicely formatted pipe delimited CSV. And if I look at the select statement, which returns the array, and if we quickly have a look at the outputs, again, we can see a nicely formatted array. So I hope that made sense to everyone. I hope you enjoyed that demonstration. I would appreciate it if you could like and share and even possibly subscribe to my videos, because I have loads more ideas that I'd like to share with you. So thanks for watching and catch you again. Cheers.